Hello friends, in this lecture we shall discuss certain important questions relating to advanced bank management paper of CAIIB. Here we have the first question: which of the following statement is correct in relation to HRD, that is human resources development? So we are given certain statements here. First statement is, training is the learning related to a new identified job. Option B, education is the learning to prepare for a different but identified job. C, development is the learning for improvement in present job. And D, none of the above. So we are given three statements here. We have to examine these three statements and find out whether some of these statements is correct or not. सबसे पहले statement को देखा जाए, सबसे पहला statement है training के साथ जुड़ा हुआ, दूसरा education के साथ, तीसरा development के साथ. Training is the learning related to new identified job. No, training is related to learning for improving the present job. Hence, A is not correct. If A is not correct, then we can see C first. Development is the learning for improvement in the present job. Now, development is the learning which is unrelated to a specific job. It leads to overall growth of an individual. Hence, C is also not correct. Let us examine B. Education is the learning to prepare for a different but identified job. Yes, this is correct statement. If someone is to be prepared for a different job which has been identified, whatever learning takes place, that is called education. So here statement B is the correct statement. Training related to present job. So training is related to present job. Education to a different identified job. And development to growth of individual unrelated to the present or specified job. So this already I have discussed. Ab hum second question ko dekhe. Current ratio of ABC Limited is 1.5:1. Quick ratio is 1:1. Quick current assets include cash, debtors and stock. If total current assets are 600, what is the amount of stock and current liabilities? So this information is given and these are the options given. Option A, 400 and 400. Option B, 400 and 200. Option C, 300 and 300. And option D, 200 and 400. इस question को निकालने के लिए सबसे पहले हमें quick assets और current liability के amount को calculate करना होगा. Now it is not very difficult to calculate amount of current liability. If current ratio is 1.5:1 and current assets are 600, then current liability will be 600 divided by 1.5, that is 400. So current ratio will be 400. When current ratio is 400 and quick ratio is 1:1, this means the quick assets will also be equal to 400. So current liability will be 400 and amount of quick assets will also be 400. Out of total current assets, if we exclude cash and debtors which are quick assets, we are left with the stock. So 600 minus 400, 200 will be the amount of stocks. So this means 200 will be amount of stock and 400 is the amount of current liabilities. So we can see the solution in writing also. Current liabilities hum kaise nikal rahe? Current assets divided by current ratio. So this is amount of current liabilities. Now amount of cash and debtors. Since quick ratio is 1:1, means the current liabilities are equal to quick assets. So quick assets are 400. Out of total current assets, agar hum reduce kar dete amount of quick assets, we get amount of stocks. Hence, option D is the correct answer. Let us now go to question number 3. Z had a fixed deposit of 2 years which matured on November 12, 2017. With 8% per annum rate of interest, he received maturity proceeds of 33,560 with quarterly compounding. How much he had deposited 2 years back? इस क्वेश्चन में हमें फ्यूचर वैल्यू दिया गया है, एनुअल रेट ऑफ इंटरेस्ट दिया गया है, लेकिन कंपाउंडिंग इसमें क्वार्टरली है. 2 इयर्स का पीरियड है और अगेन क्वार्टरली कंपाउंडिंग है. सो ये हमारे ऑप्शंस हैं. अब इसको सॉल्व करने के लिए फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल हमें रेट ऑफ इंटरेस्ट को क्वार्टरली में कन्वर्ट करना होगा और इसी प्रकार से 2 इयर्स को पीरियड को हमने क्वार्टर्स में कैलकुलेट करना होगा. सो 2 इयर्स के हमारे पास 8 क्वार्टर्स बनते हैं और 8% पर एनम इंटरेस्ट रेट हमारा 2% पर क्वार्टर बन जाएगा. नाउ वी कैन कैलकुलेट द प्रेजेंट वैल्यू. वी आर गिवन फ्यूचर वैल्यू. सो दिस इज फ्यूचर वैल्यू. फ्यूचर वैल्यू को अगर हम डिवाइड कर दें 1+r रेज टू पावर n के साथ, तो यहां पे रेट ऑफ इंटरेस्ट क्वार्टरली 2% है. सो 1+r मींस 1.02 एंड देयर आर 8 टाइम इंटरवल्स, 8 क्वार्टर्स हैं. सो वी गेट दिस वैल्यू. सो दिस इज द वैल्यू व्हिच द कस्टमर हैड डिपॉजिटेड 2 इयर्स बैक और इसके लिए उसको अभी मिलेंगे 33,560 रुपीस. Let us now go to question number 4. In Hicks-Hansen synthesis, relating to rate of interest, the LM curve is derived from. Hicks or Hansen ka jo synthesis hai, usme do prakar ke curves hai. One curve relates to LM and other is IS. Aur ye hamare options hai. Option 1, from liquidity preference theory of interest. Option 2, classical theory of interest. Option C, modern theory of interest. Option D, a mix of all the above theories of interest. Hicks-Hansen synthesis do theories ke upar based hai, Keynes theory of liquidity preference and classical theory of interest. क्लासिकल थ्योरी ऑफ इंटरेस्ट से बनता है आईएस कर्व, इनकम एंड सेविंग, और एलएम कर्व डिराइव होता है लिक्विडिटी प्रेफरेंस थ्योरी ऑफ केन्स. सो आवर ऑप्शन आंसर इज ए, एलएम कर्व इज डिराइव फ्रॉम केन्स लिक्विडिटी प्रेफरेंस थ्योरी एंड आईएस कर्व जो कि इसका दूसरा पार्ट है, दैट कर्व इज ड्रॉन फ्रॉम इनकम सेविंग एंड दैट रिलेट्स टू क्लासिकल थ्योरी ऑफ इंटरेस्ट. Well friends, let us now go to question number 5. Deposits of XYZ Bank Limited increased from 2000 billion in 2016 to 2170 billion in 2017. Thereafter to 2354 billion in 2018 at a constant growth rate. What was the amount of deposits in 2015 at the same growth rate? यहाँ पे हमें उसने 2016 का डिपॉजिट दिया है, 2017 का दिया है, 2018 का दिया है. And this growth is at a constant rate. And we have to find out what was the amount of deposit of 2015. And rate to be taken the same which is happening here. and these are our options. Now, इस क्वेश्चन को सॉल्व करने के लिए फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वी हैव टू फाइंड आउट दैट कांस्टेंट ग्रोथ रेट. एंड हाउ डू वी कैलकुलेट कांस्टेंट ग्रोथ रेट? फ्रॉम 2000 इट इंक्रीज टू 2170. इट मीन ग्रोथ इज ऑफ 170 बिलियन. एंड 170 बिलियन डिवाइडेड बाय 2000 ये हमें दे देगा वो ग्रोथ रेट 8.5%. इसी ग्रोथ रेट के ऊपर 2170 बन गए हैं 2354 इन 2018. और इसी ग्रोथ रेट को हम यूज करेंगे फॉर मेकिंग कैलकुलेशन फॉर 2015. सो 2000 इज डिपॉजिट फॉर 2016 एंड दिस इज द रेट एट विच दिस ग्रोथ हैड टेकन प्लेस. सो 1843 this is the deposit which was there in 2015. So our option answer is B. Well friends, I am sure the contents of this video will benefit you. In case you liked this contents, please do not forget to subscribe to our channel. And thank you for watching the video.